Hello and welcome back to my channel Learn with Nikhil. So here we have taken in another sum of isometric projection where we have been given the front view and the side view and we have to draw its isometric view. So first step, always find the total width, height and depth of this figure. So front view you can see it is 70. So 70 into the height we have to calculate, it is given on the side view, as you can see 30 plus 45 plus the radius of the outer semicircle, that is 25. So calculating this 30 plus 45 plus outer radius, this radius distance 25, so total which will we get is 100. So total height is 100 and the side view depth is 80. So once we have got the three height or the dimensions of this figure, we can start with the sum. Always next step, mark a point, draw a line. This is the point O. As you can see, the front view is on the left side of the point O. So here will be the front view. So this side 70 millimeter will be the front view. Side view will be here, it is the width is 80, so you know how the space requires, how much space requires, height is 100. So this is point O, left side will be the front view. Now next step, drawing the angles 30 degree, 30 degree and 90 degree. So 30 degree mark a point, 90 degree and then 30 degree. And through these three reference lines, we will draw a cube. So we'll draw a rectangular box. First, draw three lines. These are the three base reference lines. Then mark the dimension. Front view, width is 70. So here we'll be drawing the front view. This is the height 100. And this is the side view depth, that is 80. And from these three lines, we will draw a cube. So you have to draw parallel lines and through those parallel lines we will draw a cube. Just draw the parallel lines properly, otherwise your cube will not be proper and your isometric figure will be wrong. So just checking whether all the points are placed properly, dimensions. Now drawing with the front view, as you can see we have 15, 15 from both the sides. So this distance is 15. This distance is 15. And the center remaining is 40, which is given. So this 15 and 14. Now the height, this is the projection. The height given is 30. This height is 30. So drawing that straight, this height is 30 and it is on the other end as well. So this two lines has been drawn. Now we'll join this line, we'll draw it lightly. As you can see, the center part we have an extension above, so I'll just draw it lightly. Now you can see this extension straight line from the front view, but from the side view you can see it is a slant line and also you have an extension above. This distance is 0.5 centimeters, that is 5 millimeter. As on one side it is given 30 and on the other side it is given 35. So this distance is 35, this is 30, so this is 5 millimeter. So before the slant line starts, we have a straight line of 5 mm. Now, the thickness of this slant line is 18, which is given. So from the center point, we have marked the center and from center, we will mark 9 mm on both the side. So here 9 mm and here 9 mm. So total width will be 18 mm. So we'll join this dark line now. and center we will get 18 millimeter. Now the extension of 5 millimeter, it is straight above, so taking reference line here, first we will draw light line straight upwards and then we'll draw a dark line of 5 millimeter. So this is 5 millimeter. This is 5 millimeter. Okay, so this part is done, this small extension straight upwards. Now the inner side, we have a height of 15 millimeter. So raising it up, first lightly I'll draw. So this height is 15 millimeter, make it dark. Here also 15, and then we'll join it. Next, moving to the next step. So on the side view, you can see the total length is 80 millimeters. So this is 80 millimeter, you have to draw it. Straight dark line you can draw directly. This is 80 millimeters. Now, next, moving upward to a height of 30, you can see there is one more dark line, that means there is a bend from there. So I'll increase this height to 30. As you know, whenever there is a dark line, that means there is a bent or there is a slant line or there is a curve from there. Drawing parallel line through this 30, we'll join this. This part has been done. This is this rectangular box. Now this is upward at 45, but it is not from the end, it is inside. So inside, the distance given is 26 on the top. So I'll move this inside, taking parallel line as a reference. First we'll draw a light line, we'll make complete this box at the back side also. So I'll just join these two lines. So this is this box rectangle at the back side. So we'll get an idea how to draw it and how to place this figure. Now this is inward at 26, so this total length is 70. So from here 26 inside, other side also 26 you can draw, but that will be hidden as you can see later. I have to increase this upward at height of 45, and after that there is a semicircle. So I'll increase this at a height of 45. I'll make it dark till 45. Now from here we have a semicircle on this plane, so we'll draw a square. You know the procedure to draw a semicircle. From the three-dimensional view, it looks like an ellipse shape. So we need to draw a square with the diameter. So radius given is 25. So we'll draw a square with diameter as 50. So from this point, I'll keep it at the center, that is 2.5 centimeter or 25 millimeter, and we'll draw a straight line. And at this plane only, we'll construct a square. So this is 50. As we want to draw the square or the semicircle on this plane, so we'll draw the square according to that. So our square will be at this plane, on the front plane. So drawing the square with sides as 50. So this distance, I'll mark it 50. This as reference, I'll complete this square. So this square of side 50 is done. Here will be the semicircle. So you know the procedure to draw the semicircle. First we have to join the longest diagonal. So this is the longest diagonal. I'll draw it lightly as there will be many lines, and from the opposite end we'll draw it at the midpoint. So marking the midpoints on all the four planes, and from the opposite end we'll join it. Draw all these lines very lightly as we'll get confused. For semicircle we require only 2 points. For circle we require all these 4 points, but I am just drawing all the 4 points. So for drawing semicircle we'll require this point and this point. So for drawing the semicircle, here we'll draw the curve, this curve. So here will be the curve. So taking pointer this, radius as this, we'll draw the curve starting from this end. You can see we have to draw this curve. And then keeping the pointer here, take radius as this and draw the other curve. It will start from this point. I'll draw this lightly at first, as we also want to draw a straight line as it is intersecting. As you can see there is a slant line, so I'll keep the scale here and I'll just coincide with the tangent, coincide to its tangent. As you can see, as it is coincided, and I'll draw a dark line. So you have to arrange your scale in a way as it is tangent to the semicircle. So a smooth line comes. Now I'll dark the remaining part of the semicircle, because we don't need to draw the whole semicircle, as you can see in the question itself. So this smooth part is done. Now we have to do it same, as it has a thickness of 18. So for drawing the thickness, we just have to move the points 18 on the left side. So first I am drawing light lines. I am moving these points on the left side as its thickness. And I'll mark the point 18 on the left side. So from here, from this point, I'll mark a point 18 on the left side. From here, so this is the new point which is shifted on the left side. It will start from this line and it will end at this line. So I am projecting the start and the end point also. So keeping the pointer here, taking radius as this, then shifting this point 18. So I've shifted this point and I'll draw the curve. So look, the curve, how much to draw? It will start from this point and it will end till here, same as the first time we have drawn it. So this curve part is shifted. Same we have to do with this curve also, taking this as a radius. First you have to shift the point. So I'll keep this radius on the compass ready. I'll shift this point 18 on the left side. So this is the new point which is shifted. Now keeping the pointer here, I'll draw the curve. I'm drawing it darkly, but you can draw this lightly at first, as we want to join the slant line as well. I have not extended till the end the semicircle. Now taking this as parallel line, from this point I'll join to the semicircle. This slant part is done. joining this line will give you the image of the backside curve. It will be like a straight line. So joining this. Now moving toward the next step, that is the circle with diameter given as 30. So again, same steps. We have to draw a square with diameter as 30. So square with sides as 30. So again from the center. So the center line is at 45 above. So from this point, again, we'll draw a straight line, light, with side as 30. So I'll keep this at 1.5 or 15 millimeter. I'll mark above a point and below. So this total height is 30. Mark the points carefully and remember where we have marked, because as there are many points, you'll get confused. Draw the straight line. Draw the parallel line from these two points. Then on those lines again, mark the center point, as this length is 50, so 2.5, and then from that 2.5 point, 1.5 on both sides, so this is 30. So again, draw those parallel lines. So at the center, we have drawn a square with side of 30. Then next step, the diagonal line is already present, which is joining the longest diagonal. Now same process, find out the midpoint at 1.5 mark, and from the other diagonal, join. This will be the first point. Same method, join, center point. This will be the second point, midpoint. You can see it will overlap the point we have marked. Just remember the points, as we have to draw the curve from them. You can mark it, make it a bit darker. So these are the four points. From these four points, we'll draw a circle. So three dimensionally, the circle will look like an ellipse. So keeping the pointer here, radius as this much, we'll draw the curve. For proper circle explanation, you can refer to my video where I have explained how to draw the circle. Same radius, draw the curve. Keeping the pointer here, take this as radius, draw the curve. Keep the pointer here, with this as radius, draw the curve. So we have got the circle. Now the circle depth also we have to find out, as at this angle we'll see the inner circle cut also. So we'll just shift the point, this point on left side at 18, as we have done earlier with the semicircle. So marking this point and shifting it 18 on the left side. So this is the shifted point. Now with compass, this diameter, we'll keep it here and draw the cut. This is the inner cut of the circle. So on this angle, the inner circle cut will be visible. I've shown it in Tinkercad software also, 3D software, where you can view this cut. Now just drawing the parallel lines, and we'll complete with this image. So these are just the cut parts which will be visible. Join this. Also this line will be there, as this is the cut part, the inner shape will be visible. So now this looks like a complete three-dimensional object. I'll mark the front view. So arrow X represents front view. Just one line is remaining. Now from here we have drawn the bent part. This bent line, this line will be dark as it is bent from that part. That's the only part remaining, and we have done with our sum. So our whole three-dimensional figure is constructed. This is this elongated part, the curve part, straight 45, circle, this is hidden in the front view, and we have done with the figure. Just marking of the dimensions. Whatever dimensions are given in the question, mark them as it is. But just look how I'm projecting the dimensions. That is really important. It should be aligned with your figure. And we have completed with this. Thank you for watching. Do subscribe to my channel. See you in the next lecture. If you have any doubts, do let me know in the comment section.